Hey Glickstex, this is Captain Yeet here for you for another Glickstex episode review. This is going to be season 2 episode 3 titled Ralphie Bear is back. So let's get into it. So this episode starts off with Miko just actually doing her job. She has a little tablet on, looking around the store, tapping on the tablet, until eventually the TV pops on. It's a commercial for Joystick Juniors. I'm pretty sure it's the arcade we've been seeing throughout this whole series that they keep going back to. Anyway, Joystick Junior is finally bringing back this animatronic named Ralphie Bear that does like little birthday parties. They're finally bringing it back in like a whole commercial for it, added a little jingle to it. Miko looks kind of shocked, and Fog comes out of nowhere. He goes, "Did you hear that, Miko?" Miko freaks out and goes to hit him with her tablet, but he doesn't duck it on purpose. He was just ducking just to go, "I can't believe it." Like, you know, he does that, but he ducks under the tablet just in time. So he got off. Bob got off. Anyway, Miko's like, "What? Well, what is this Ralphie Bear thing? I never heard of it." He goes, "Are you serious?" He grabs Miko, puts her down in the training facility, little place that they have in Hinobi, and he's showing her the whole history of Ralphie Bear. And she's sitting in a chair with some popcorn and a drink, and she goes, "Yo, Five, we don't really have to do it. Okay, I guess we're doing this." And he explains about how, you know, Ralphie Bear used to come out for people's birthdays, for little kids' birthdays, and there was like a little whole skit to it. At first, this other animatronic named Smash Suit. Yo, I just, I literally had a Smashy Vic Vaughn's, Smash Vic Vaughn's mom? No. Okay, I'm back. I got it now. It was Cakey Von Smasher. That was her name. Cakey Von Smasher. I knew I had it in my head. I just watched the episode 20 minutes ago. But Cakey Von Smasher. That's her name. Anyway, Cakey Von Smasher will come out and try to smash the cake of whoever's birthday it was. Then Ralphie Bear will show up, fight her, and then boom, like the day is saved for Ralphie Bear. Woo, and it's like a little jingle you had to sing to get Ralphie Bear out here. And Five is like ecstatic that they're finally bringing Ralphie Bear back. He is so happy to see him back. And Miko's like, "Yeah, I can see that, Five." We get the little cute scene of Five hugging Miko. And Miko, I mean, she's excited for her boy. She's not that excited, but she's like, "Okay, I mean, I can see you're happy, Five, but let's just settle down on this hypeness." He also mentioned that they use Hinobi tech inside the animatronics, so that's pretty cool. Anyway, he says, but 10 years ago, they stopped having Ralphie come out because of the birthday ruiner. Really? He says, yeah, one day, you know, everything's going crazy and good. The next day, boom, he's gone to never be shown again. But after 10 long years, we finally got him back. And Five also says there is a theory out there that this person was able to make, I mean, this person is the birthday ruiner. It's so funny. So look at this picture. So he found this picture on the security cams. He says, now this picture got released like a few like weeks or so after the whole incident. We can see Ralphie's bare head is decapitated. And the cops got somebody off to the side. A little girl, a little boy over there. I wonder who that could be. I don't know. Anyway, that is the birthday ruiner. They did something. Well, decapitated Ralphie Bear, and he's never been seen again. Not good. Not good. Miko's acting like she has no idea why this could have happened. And even if, I mean, she has no idea. She's acting like she doesn't know what the heck is going on with Ralphie Bear. But she's like, fine. I mean, even if that, you know, the birthday ruin that did ruin that one birthday, they've been having birthday parties at Joystick Jr. for years now. They didn't stop just because Ralphie got decapitated. See, I mean, Five is like, yeah, but they have no Ralphie now. They have no essence of their birthday, which really sucks. We cut over to Five, and that was so funny. We cut over to Five and Miko inside the car. Five is still talking about Joystick Jr. and Ralphie Bear. She goes, you know what, Five? Let's just stop talking about that. I'm just kind of getting on my nerves. Then Phil calls them, and he goes, hey, I got a mission for you guys. Miko's like, yes, thank you. It's at Joystick Jr.'s. She goes, what? Apparently, Phil knows the guy that runs Joystick Jr.'s. They're pretty good friends. Five is like really excited about that and feels like, yeah, I make friends wherever I go. Anyway, as you know, arcades are hotspots for glitches. So before they have that grand reopening of Ralphie the Bear, there's going to be a lot of kids there. I need you two to go in there before it opens, scan all the arcades, make sure there's no glitches, and get out. Five is like, are you serious? we get to go in there before it opens. He goes, Miko, we can go in there and take pictures with Ralphie and play the arcades. And Phil's like, whoa, player. You're supposed to go in there, scan for glitches, and get out. No, don't mess with the animatronics. Plus, Jimmy literally told me, that's the guy that owned the Joystick Jr. Jimmy literally told me to tell you guys to not mess with the animatronic robots. Five is like, Phil, I got you. There is no way I would ever, in a cut to them walking inside of Joystick Jr.'s, ever not take a picture with Ralphie. I gotta do this. And now they're inside of Joystick Jr.'s. Let me cut past this part because I got through it. Then we get the theme song. Right after the theme song, we cut over to Phil, and he's just drinking coffee, and on his coffee mug is some tickets, like Chuck E. Cheese tickets, and he's like, what the heck? And he's going, like, you know, he's pulling it up to a drawer. He opens a drawer, and there's a buttload. It's, like, filled to the rim of tickets. He goes, and he thinks about him going to Joystick Jr.'s, buying something with the tickets. He calls Jimmy. He goes, yo, Jimmy, is those tickets, are they still intact? Like, you know they're old. You know, I might have a few old ones. I don't know. Can I still use them for getting a prize? He goes, yeah, sure. Really? Okay. Well, you know what? I'm going to actually go over there and check on my, you know, assistants to make sure they're doing everything okay. I'm going to make a personal visit. He goes, okay, yeah, that's fine, but just to make sure. And then Phil hangs up. He gets really excited, grabs all his tickets, and then bolts into his car. He wanted something. He wants something. That's funny because that's literally the strat to do to get anything like Chuck E. Cheese, because I never got anything on the top shelf. Because, you know, it's like 1,000-plus tickets or like 500-something tickets to get up there. Like, you know, like, you can have the most tickets in the universe when you go there for one day, and then you get, like something out of the glass or something like maybe on the wall, but the top of the cool stuff, you need like a billion tickets. you had to take your tickets home and stack them up. My cousins did that. I don't know if they ever went back and get it, but I remember one of them at my cousin's house, and they had like a huge bucket full of tickets. They've been taking them home and like stacking them up so they can get something on the top shelf. I don't know if you're allowed to do that. I would think so. You will be able to. But I don't know, honestly, but that's funny because that's like legit what's be happening. Anyway, Five, he is very excited about, you know, coming into the Joystick Jr. to see Ralphie. And Miko's like, look, Five, you're the responsible one. We're supposed to be searching for glitches inside the arcade machines. Please come help me. He goes, I will. I just got to look at the Ralphie show real quick. He goes inside the Ralphie room. He's super excited, looking around. He is just ecstatic. Miko's like, oh my goodness, master of all chiefs. Yeah, that's a nice one. We'll try to put that in the thumbnail. So he goes, master of all chiefs, why are you so excited about this stupid Ralphie Bear birthday? He goes, because I never had one before, okay? Miko's like, what? But you know everything about Ralphie Bear. He goes, I know. But when I was a kid, I always asked my dad if I could try to have a birthday at Joystick Jr.'s to see Ralphie Bear. But we didn't have enough money. So I used to mow people's lawns. I used to have a little lemonade stand. We used to look a little kid of Five doing all these like random jobs. I even worked inside the food truck with my grandpa and grandma. And we finally scraped together enough money to book a reservation. But the day I got there, Miko's like, oh, Ralphie was gone. Exactly. But now he's back, so I can actually see him. Miko's like, okay, fine. Even that origin story brought me to tears. Let's do this. And Five like, let's do this. So he like wipes his hand over Miko's face, and there's like a little birthday hat on her head. She goes, what the? Did you already have? And looks at Five, and he already has a cupcake. He has a, I don't know what that thing is called, but you know, you blow into it, it makes that sound. He goes, and he has a birthday hat already too. She goes, huh. Okay. Like he already had this ready. He already had this ready to go, which is so funny. Here's the funny scene when she goes, all right, fine, let's do this. And he already had the birthday hat and everything ready to go. Look at this. Yes! Boom! What the? Did you already? it's too bright. You don't get to see the cake. I hate that sometimes. Sometimes when the scene is too bright or something's too bright, it won't show up. Sometimes it's because of the lamp, but I need the lamp so it can look clearer. And other times, it's just too bright. Other times, yeah, that scene is just way too bright. Anyway, They both sit down. Five starts up No, I forgot a funny scene. Five types in his name, because it's supposed to say his name during the whole like little skit with the animatronics. So he types in his name and he says, okay, your name is in, Hector. And Miko's like, what the heck? Your name is Hector? Five was like, yeah, you thought my parents named me High Five? And that was funny. That's like the first time they ever said it. It's kind of funny because when you get hired at a job, wouldn't you say your real name? But, you know, maybe you say, I want to be called my nickname. Like, you know, throughout all of season one, up to season two now, everybody has called him High Five. That's his nickname. I mean, that's me. My nickname is, well, you see right there, Buddy. Literally, my whole family calls me Buddy. I remember some of my cousins don't even know my real name because everybody called me Buddy. My mom only calls me my real name when she's mad, which isn't a lot. But other than that, it's just only Buddy. that's my family nickname. It's just Buddy. Anyway, after that, they sit down at the table. The little skit starts to happen. Keke Von Smasher comes out, and she goes, I'm going to smash Hector. Like, you know, the robot saying it. Cake. And then Ralphie's supposed to pop out, but it's like a little trap door on the stage that he's supposed to pop out of, and the trap door is not opening. So Ralphie's just constantly hitting it. And Five is like, oh no, there's something wrong with it. Okay, Miko, I'm going to go stop the sequence. You try to get the door open, and then we can start over. Miko walks over to open the door, and then eventually Ralphie's able to pop out, and it scares Miko. She jumps up and kicks his head off. She jumps up and kicks Ralphie's head off. And then the cake gets smashed all over Five, and there's a glitch inside of Keke Von Smasher. So she starts glitching out, and she looks at Five, and she goes, Cake, Hector is one. So now she's trying to kill or smash Hector, which is Five, you know. So, you know, she just keeps saying over and over, I'm here to smash Hector. Like that, she just keeps saying that for like the rest of the episode. Anyway, obviously Five is like, oh my goodness, no, she wants to kill me. And then Miko's like, oh, I don't think that's the only thing. She's also glitched. So they take out their, you know, god licks, they start to shoot at it, and their plasma like blast or ricocheting off of the body. They're like, what the heck? Why isn't this working? And then, you know, later on we do find out it's like the metal shell around like the circuit boards inside and stuff, because it's not an actual glitch. Like, you know, like you're just making a form itself so you can shoot it. It's like inside of a metal Iron Man suit, basically. That's basically what's going on. It's like inside an Iron Man suit. So it starts to chase them around. Eventually, Miko and Five go to like a back door and close it. Miko puts like a time stopper on the door, and like a bulkiness, so it's stronger, because she makes the door stronger so this animatronic can't just bust through it, and it puts like a time delay on it. So they run down the stairs, they go over to another door, and it's like a creepy hallway. And then Five is hacking the other door, they walk through a door, Miko does the time stuff on the door, they go down the stairs, and there's a creepy hallway. They run down this hallway and go to another door, but it's locked, so Five is hacking it. And Five is mad at Miko because Miko just kicked Ralphie's head off. And Miko's like, Five, can you just calm down? Like, nobody cares about this stupid, creepy bear. Like, this thing is trying to kill us. Let's just focus on what we're doing. But you smashed his head off. But you kicked his head off. Like, they're arguing. And Five eventually is able to unlock the door. They grab an arcade machine, push it in front of the door. And you just constantly keep hearing banging on the door because, you know, Keke Von Smasher is trying to get in. They turn around when they get into the next room, and it's like a duck animatronic. Miko freaks out, kicks the head off that thing. And then Five catches her in her hands, just like Scooby-Doo would, and Shaggy, which is pretty funny. That's like the exact pose Scooby and Shaggy would do when they get scared, like, they just grab each other. That was pretty funny. That was good. That was good. I'm going to keep the towel off for the rest of the episode. I already get sick of getting up and getting now. I already got sick of that. Anyway, Five suits the Five suits like the fabric off of the duck's head. And he goes, yo, can you stop doing that, Miko? Jeez. He suits the fabric off the animatronic duck's head. He goes, oh, I get it. Like I just said, he goes, I see. The glitch is inside the circuit boards, inside like the metal casing. That's why our blasts aren't working. So we have to get his head off and get the glitch out of there. Miko's like, I got you. She brings out the Miko hammer. She goes, Miko, smash! And Five was like, no, we're not doing that. So we get a funny scene. I mean, this scene was cool when she brought out her hammer. this is really nice, cool looking scene. And that's like a Hulk reference. Hulk smash, Nico smash. Five goes, no, we're not destroying any more animatronics. How about we do this? So he brings out this huge ball of energy. And I'm thinking like, yo, what is he finna bring out? And it's just a screwdriver. Like, it's just a little screwdriver. He goes like, what the heck are we gonna do with that? We changed her batteries? We're not destroying any more animatronics, okay, Miko? I'm gonna carefully take her head off and get the glitch out. And when he says that, we don't hear any more banging on the door. Miko's like, where did it go? Why is it not banging no more? Five is like, huh, I got it. He hacks into the cameras, because this is like a Five Nights reference. Basically, this whole episode is a Five Nights Freddy's reference. Anyway, he hacks into the cameras, and she goes, well, you can do that? He goes, yeah, all the tech inside this place is Hanobi. So I can hack into the cameras. He has the cameras on his gauntlet. He's tapping each camera, and eventually, Keiki Von Smasher pops up in the camera, freaks them both out. Then she pops into the room. They start to fight her a little bit, and then Five jumps on her head, can't get her head off, like, safely, and he goes, you know what? This idea isn't working. Miko, what do we do now? Miko smash. Go ahead. She tries to hit Keiki Von Smasher, but Keiki Von Smasher throws Five at Miko, and they both hit the wall. And then Five is like, Miko, you know what? I'm sorry. You were right. I'm supposed to be the responsible one. And I just had this stupid kid obsessing with Ralphie Bear, and now we're going to get killed by this thing. And there's a poster on the wall. He goes, was he always this creepy? Miko, yes, he's always been creepy. He always haunted my dreams as a child. What? Keiki Von Smasher stomps her foot on the ground, and one of the floor panels cracks in, and Miko falls over, and she rips the poster off the wall, and it's a secret vent. And she goes, oh, jinkies, look at this. Scooby-Doo. Like, that was pretty good. I like that. I love Scooby-Doo. She goes, oh, jinkies, look at this. And so Five and Miko jump in the vent, and they go into like this random basement with like a ton of different broken like arcade machines and controllers and stuff like that. And Five is like, you said you never heard of Ralphie Bear this morning. You had me go on and on about the whole history, but just now you said he haunted your dreams. Are you lying to me? She goes, okay, Five, I'll tell you the truth. She said when she first moved to this town, she was a new kid. She had no friends at all. And she got a little pity invite to a little girl's birthday party. And it was here. And then, and then we see, like, we actually go into the flashback and we see little kid Miko. Oh, don't she look cute? Look at little kid Miko. Look at her. She looks so, and her hair is also, she dyed her hair even back in the day. That's pretty cute. She even dyed her hair back in the day. Because that's not, oh, I hit my table. Little kid Miko, that's sweet. Anyway, the little skit plays out. Miko's the only one that doesn't know what's happening. Ralphie Bear jumps out. She freaks out. She even kicked his head off back then as a kid. She has some crazy strength to do that as a kid. Some crazy strength. Look at this. She jumps up and kicks his head off when she was a kid. That is wild. That is wild. The head flies up, destroys the little girl's cake. Everybody's crying. And she goes, after that, nobody saw Miko. Everybody just saw the birthday ruiner. And Five was like, oh, so you were the birthday ruiner? And she goes, yes, look at me and tremble. For I am the villain of your origin story. I am the birthday ruiner. Miko looks really sad. Five goes over to her and hugs her. She goes, Five, you know I'm the one that destroyed Ralphie Bear, right? He goes, yeah, but all these years all these years I was sad about Ralphie Bear getting destroyed by some horrible person. Just like the little cute scene when he hugs her. But I never really sat down to thought about, what if that horrible person was just a scary little kid that had to, like, you know, that freaked out like you? I never really thought about it like that. She goes, well, thanks. You're the first in the club. Nobody ever thought to think about that. He goes, hey, that's their fault. That they didn't get to know you like I do. You're my best friend, Miko. And then he walks to the side. She goes, aw, you know, you're really sweet when there's an animatronic trying to kill us. You know that, right? That was a really nice scene. I loved that. I love that scene. Anyway, they walk into another room. Avon Smasher is still going crazy upstairs. And Father goes, hey, I see a door. And then he goes, I mean, like I said, throughout this whole episode, Keiki Von Smasher just keeps saying the same thing over and over. I'm going to smash Hector. And Miko's like, why does he keep saying that? And Fava, like, well, her, like, visual whatever is, like, damaged. So instead of seeing Cake that she's supposed to smash, she sees me. Glitch is supposed to go on, like, a program. So if it was, like, the old school Donkey Kong thing, he's just going to keep throwing barrels. So she's supposed to see Ralphie Bear, and he's supposed to defeat her. But Ralphie Bear never came out. So now she's stuck on a loop. He's like, oh. Kiki Von Smasher comes out, chases Five through another door. Miko, she falls over, and she grabs a Ralphie Bear helmet. She goes, it's stuck on a loop. And Ralphie Bear's supposed to come out. I get it now. Five is still running away from Kiki Von Smasher. He eventually gets over to the roof, and he's like, oh no, this is bad. All I wanted was a birthday, and I just wanted Ralphie to save me. He starts singing the jingle, and then Miko in a Ralphie Bear costume comes out. Your pal Ralphie Bear jumps up. And then Miko's like, hey, look, it's not saying it wants to kill you anymore. It's not after you. Five's like, yeah, I know, because it's after you. And Miko's like, uh-oh. And Miko starts to fight it for a little while. I'm like, wow, Miko has some crazy strength to it, because it punches at her, and she grabs her, like, the animatronic hands and pushes it back. And then Miko also gives it a mean uppercut. Look at this. They're starting to, like, box. Miko's, like, head spins around, kind of funny. And then Miko, boom, gives this thing the meanest uppercut I've ever seen. Anyway, they continue to fight until eventually they fall off the roof. Miko is holding onto the legs, and the animatronic is holding onto her legs, like her actual legs, until they both fall into the water. Whoa, the Kiki Von Smasher falls into the water and fights with the grabber just in the nick of time, brings her up, and he goes, you saved me, Ralphie. Thank you so much, Miko. You know I'm still Miko, right? Just give me this moment. She goes, okay, partner, you got it. She's like, Five, you know what? Okay, you got it, man. You got it. Anyway, very end of the episode, Jimmy, he comes over, and Miko and Five are like, sir, you can't come in the arcade right now. There's something going on. He goes, what's the matter? There's something Glitch. Miko's like, how does he know about glitches? He goes, hey, you don't run the biggest arcade in town and don't see a glitch or two. That makes a lot of sense. He probably keeps seeing glitches. They keep having to come over here, kill them, and then wipe them. He probably gets sick of it, so probably just told him. So he's just going to keep seeing them. That's not exactly what they just said, but that'll make the most sense. That'll make a lot of sense. Anyway, they explained to him exactly what happened about the backstory with Miko getting scared and what just happened now. And it was kind of cute because Miko, like, her teeth gets really big and smiling while they're trying to explain to him that they just wrecked his whole place because of everything that just happened. She had, like, a really big smile on. Oh, look. Yeah, you can see. She has a really big smile. And you see Phil, he finally comes over, and he's, like, goofing around and bumping around. He eventually comes over. He goes, yo, Ralphie. Jimmy, he says that, guys, I didn't take out Ralphie because of one kid, like, birthday mistake because you kicked his head off as a kid. I took him out because he was creepy. I mean, kids were freaking out all the time. He even gave me the willies. I took him out, okay? And they go, oh, so you're not the birthday ruiner. Miko's like, hey, I'm not. Anyway, Phil, he comes over. He goes, yo, Jimmy, I got 536 tickets to coin in. And Miko and Five will look at him. Hey, what's the matter with you? All those stories. Well, I'm basically at the end. Jimmy, he says that he took Raphael because, you know, the whole freaking out. Phil comes over. He says he got the tickets. And then he goes, I got a new animatronic. I got Ralphie Boar because Ralphie Bear freaked out kids too much. And this thing looks even creepier than the bear. I don't know what his idea was. Look at this thing. Phil, he freaks out, jumps up and kicks the head off. And Five and Miko like, yo, what? That was pretty funny. And then, wow, I actually got through this whole episode without having it. Normally, I have to, like, do two or three takes because it cuts me out. Or, you know, like, a lot of episodes in season one. Not every single one, but a lot of episodes in season one will cut me off when I'm right at the end. That didn't happen this time. Thank you. Thank you. So, that's the episode I got for you guys today. So, like, share, and subscribe. I see you all later. I thank you all up there for being wonderful, beautiful human beings. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye. All right.